Welcome to another short Let's Play, a short game, A Date in the Park, which is free on Steam by Cloak and Dagger Games. I recently played their other game, The Terrible Old Man, based on a H.P. Lovecraft story. So this one is looks like to be a good diversion. You can actually load, but I think this game only takes an hour to play, which means we'll probably take 2 hours to play it, because I'm going to be reading everything. I read all the things, so if you guys don't like someone who reads all the things, then what else do I have to say? Wrong video for you to watch, I suppose. Anyway, new game. This is like, kind of like, starts out as like a standard, you know, girl of your dreams thing, and then takes a turn, from what I understand. And perhaps not necessarily for the better. That animation, though. Well, this is it. Tapada das Necessidades. Something with necessity. I can't believe I've only been in Lisbon for a week, and already I've met the most beautiful woman in the city. Yes, you've been there for a whole week, and already you've seen every woman in the city. Catarina is her name. I met her in a bar last night, and we talked for hours. She was absolutely enchanting. The last thing she said as she hopped into the taxi was, "Meet me tomorrow at the Tapada das Necessidades by the duck pond at 12 p.m. And, well, here I am. I'm on time, so hopefully she's in there somewhere. By a duck pond, I'm guessing. Left-click on something to interact with it. Right-click to look at it. Move the cursor to the top of the screen to access your inventory and settings. Once inside the park, you may right-click on exits to automatically travel to them. Good to know. Do note that most backgrounds scroll, so be sure to look around. Now, there's no sound in this, so hopefully it doesn't get loud. All we can do is save, restart, quit, etc. It's a Polaroid photo that Catarina took of the both of us at the bar last night. Boy, she's beautiful, right? She's alright. He looks drunk, to say the least. It's my wallet. There's a few bank cards in here, some euros, and old receipts. It's an old handkerchief. I prefer using these to tissues. Saves the environment a few trees. Combine with the picture. That's ridiculous. Put the picture in the wallet. Nope, that'd be ridiculous. Okay. Street lamp. Climbing the pole seems rather unnecessary. The signs are all in Portuguese, but I assume they're saying something about parking or traffic. Lisbon is a great city for walking around in. I don't think I will even need to buy a car. This door seems to lead into the wall of the park. The door is locked, but I don't think I need to go in here. Look at self? No. I've just got here. I'm not going to leave without seeing Catarina. The road winds back down into central Lisbon. There's a bit of a hike up that hill. Okay. It's a rubbish bin. I don't have anything to throw away. I can see someone lurking in the shadows beyond the window. Really? Hello? Disculpe, deseja entrar no parque? English? Now. O billete de entrada custa 3 euros. 3 euros? Ah, euros. 3 euros? Sim, 3 euros. I think I need to give him 3 euros to enter the park. The opening times closes late. The park closes late. A heavy iron gate keeps the vagabonds out at night, I suppose. Or in? The gate is open. Yes, it's a door. I'm guessing that's a private room in there. The park looks lush. Are we supposed to pay euros here? €3? Here's the entrance fee. Obrigado. Agora já poder entrar no parque. Thank you. Tom un mapa do parque. Tejan un resto de un bom dia. Have a good day. Rest something. Have a good rest of your day? I don't know. Oh, thanks. He's given me a map of the park. Sweet. Judging by the quality of this map, I don't think the park authority here has a very big budget. Pretty big place, though. There seems to be a couple of ponds. So you are here. Pond. Is that a pond as well? Okay, so the map is not in our inventory, but it's there. Entrar de parque. The park stretches off in two directions. I can instantly see why Catarina loves this place so much. It's beautiful. Like her. The sun is shining, the birds are singing, and I've got a date to meet. I've never been what you would call lucky in love. I left behind a string of failed relationships back in London. I guess I've just never met someone who truly clicked with me. I know it's way too early to say, but I have a feeling that Catarina really does seem different to the others. I mean, I'd only just met her, and there we were, discussing our most private of thoughts with each other. Is it normal to open up so quickly to someone? I just felt so comfortable. I'd never discussed the death of my parents last year with anyone until last night. It just seemed natural, and she oozed genuine compassion. I deserve a break. That's what she said to me over and over again, with a very reassuring flash of her beautiful smile. I just can't wait to see her again. Anyway, focus. Let's find this duck pond. She's a demon. The fountain is spurting away pleasantly. Yeah, I've never played this before, guys, just in case you weren't aware. Hence the blind tag there in parentheses for the title. The water is cool and refreshing to the touch. I don't leave the park without even seeing Catarina. My god, it's a ticket office for the park. In there sits my €3, never to be seen again. Well, it'll be seen, just but not by you. The worker there doesn't speak English. There's no point disturbing him. Donation box. It's got a coin slot on the top, so I guess it's a donation box. But we already paid to get in, and then give a donation? I've already paid €3 at the gate. I don't want this place to bankrupt me. Nature. Trees line the edge of the park. I can just see the walls beyond the foliage. It's beautiful. Humans need to spend more time in places like this. Give me a tree over an iPad any day. I try not to make a habit of lurking around undergrowth. Yes, it comes at a, there's a limit to it. I just looked at the exit, but yet I moved. Is this a duck pond? Possibly, because there's a duck. And ducklings. Nah. Well, that confirms it. It's a duck pond, all right. I wonder where she is. I think she even says something about a bench beside the pond. Why am I making that up? My memory is hazy. There's another pond on the map to the north. Maybe I should check that out. That duckling seems to be having some trouble getting over the curb of the pond. The poor little duckling struggling to jump over the curb of the pond. Poor little fella. Well, somehow you think grammatically incorrect. The duck is anxiously calling for the duckling. Oh, I thought that was a duckling. I was like, that's a very... Oh, that's a cheap as a duckling. Quack. This is where Catarina told me to meet her. Well, I think so anyway. My memories of our discussions late in the evening are hazy at best. I prefer to stay on my feet. Perhaps I should take a look around the park, see if I misunderstood her meeting point. In you go, buddy. That rotoscoping animation, though. Bye. And off they go. Hopefully that gives me some good karma, reuniting mother and child. The water looks a bit stagnant, but it's pleasant enough. It's not time for a dip. Alright. We are here. I can see the entrance area down that southern path. The northern option goes deeper into the park. Okay, so there's some kind of spooky noise going around. This is a very tropical looking tree. Nice. I don't need to do anything with the tree. So I guess we're going there. Exit there. I went to the structure. It's an impressive and rather old-looking statue of a male Roman god. A small plaque at its base seems to suggest his name is Sencus. He has a heroic, though slightly smug, expression. The statue is old and crumbly. Nothing of interest here. It's some sort of emergency exit gate, which is amusing and it's secured with a multitude of heavy-duty padlocks. The gate is locked with several massive padlocks. Beyond it is a tiny staircase which spirals down the outer wall of the park. It's probably a 20-meter drop to the bottom. Lisbon is one hilly city. So I guess we're going this way. Oh, wait. Wait a second. Okay. Another junction. The sound of the birds chipping away in the trees is very peaceful. I'm loving this place. Should I make a call? It's a very old-fashioned public phone. It's dead. I guess you have to insert some coins. Should we? I used my last coins to get into the park. I've only got notes left. Besides, I don't actually have Katarina's number. It seems this is a very old-fashioned date. So it seems... Well, let's look at our map. This way goes back? Have we been here? Well, we came from here. Go this way. Yeah, I've never been there. Sculptural feature. A very grand plant pot. There's no need to climb it. I wouldn't want to topple it over. This is a charming little secluded area. I think I can see water up ahead. This is a lovely spot for a bit of lunch. I should have brought some drinks and nibbles. Drinks and nibbles. I'll come back here with Catarina. It's a romantic spot. So there's a pond up ahead. Nothing else to look at other than the picnic area, then. Ah! A human life form! I was beginning to wonder if I was alone in this place. Katarina's not here either, though, and I can't see any ducks. I guess she meant the other one. It's a bit murky, but nice. There's something very peaceful about ponds. Fantasy idea. Skinny dipping here with Catarina. Catarina. Oh, yes. As the guy with the shovel watches you. He's staring off into the bushes. There doesn't seem to be anything over there. Lost in his thoughts, perhaps. Hi there. Bom dia, senor. I'm looking for my friend. I wonder if you might have seen her. No wonder he can't speak the other language. He's not even that good in English. Disculpe, no falo inglés. Ah, I think that means no English. I'm afraid my Portuguese is nothing to write home about either. Senor, tena cuidado. Vi amo mulher extraña entre os arbustos. Okay, be careful. That's all I got out of that. Tina olha estrano para crumi maluca. Maluca. Tena cuidado, senor. I'm afraid I don't understand, but thank you for your time. He seems distracted by something in the bushes. I really do need to start learning Portuguese. The phrase book will arrive in a couple of days. I ordered one online. It can't come soon enough, really. I'm just thankful Catarina speaks perfect English. It's strange living in a country where you don't even speak the language. Strange. It just doesn't feel like you're truly there. Who knows what sort of hilarious conversations I could be having right now with this gardener if only I could pull finger and get learning. Pull finger. We don't understand each other. There's no point. He seems preoccupied with something anyway. Relationship problems? Day-to-day drudgery of work? Football results? Who knows? All I know is that those are the things I came to Lisbon to escape from. This rucksack presumably belongs to the gardener. That's not mine to rummage around in. I must rummage, you don't understand. It's a bit murky, but nice. Something very peaceful about ponds. I think I read that already. Mm. Alright, so we are... Oh, I saw something else. No. We are here. And there's nowhere else to go. She's not here. Alright, so now we go this way. What an impressive domed building. I wonder what it's for. A nice spot for some wine and cheese. There's nothing on the table. I might come back here with Catarina. It's nice to sit in the shade. It really is getting rather hot. So maybe we should seek shelter in the building. There's nothing, not even marked on the map, this building. The only place we haven't been is forward and this way. I'm guessing she must be over here. It's an odd building. There's some sort of bust figure across the way. Maybe it used to be a greenhouse or something. Shadowy alcove. There's a bust over there. I think it's of a female goddess or something. It's too shadowy to make out any features. I'm not Stretch Armstrong. It's way too far away. Stretch Armstrong. It's loud over here. Maybe I'll save. Make sure it's really there. I always do that. Yeah. Oh, those are pigeons? Oh, that's just water. Whoa, it's a pigeon feeding frenzy. Weird. Whilst these pigeons do look slightly less manky than the ones back in London, I still have no intention of touching them. More benches. Better keep looking around. The wall is rather fancy. It must be quite old as well. It's much too vertical to climb. I never was much of a climber back in school. Couldn't get up the rope in gym class. Apply handkerchief to pigeons. I don't want to mess around with these gross pigeons. They might eat me next. Alright, nothing else to look at here. An ubiquitous park bench. No doubt the location of many a romantic embrace. No such luck for me yet. I don't want to sit down. You'll sit down when I tell you to, mister. Untamed vegetation and towering trees lie beyond the wall. The wall is rather too vertical to climb over. So we can go this way or that way? Well, this way leads back. Right? Does it? Forward is... Let me just look. Oh yeah, the phone. Okay. We ended up going the other way. There's a building up ahead. Aha! Finally we have some English translation. The statue on the left is Vejovis, god of healing and goodwill. The statue on the right is Priapus, god of gardens. There's more information in Portuguese, but that's all I get in English. I remember Catarina saying she had an interest in classics. She must like these statues. It's a sign explaining the statues. Vejovis, the god of healing and goodwill, is on the left. Priapus, god of gardens, is on the right. Alright, so we got statue, door. A pipe. It's a statue of Priapus, god of gardens. Minus his head. The statue is smooth and cold to the touch and does not exhibit any signs of secret buttons or levers. It's a pipe, or drain. I guess this is where the water comes from to fill up this little pool in front of the statue. I don't want to go around sticking my hands up random dirty old pipes. Why the hell not? This is the god of healing. Goddess of healing. God of healing and goodwill. He seems to be holding some bandages. Oh, he. It's a bit heavy to pick up or move. Besides, there is nothing unusual about it. We've got these pipes, though. It's a pipe. Probably funnels water in the pool in front of the statue. I can't see anything inside it. I don't need to see the need in sticking my hand up the pipe. Okay. What if we plug it with the handkerchief? I don't need to be fiddling around with the pipe. Don't you tell me, mister. Peering through the glass doors, I can see absolutely nothing. Just a bare room. The door is locked and bolted. Alright. Okay, so we need to go around the side then. I guess... Is that the way? Okay. Contraption? Window. Graffiti. It looks like some sort of pumping device. Maybe it controls the pools in front of the statues. I have no reason to go fiddling with the pumping device. Well, I want to fill up the pools. For the hell of it. The rambling symbolism of some local teen, no doubt. It's not my job to scrub off the graffiti. It's a large window, though it doesn't appear to open. The window doesn't open. It's more of a design feature. Peering inside, all I see is an empty room with whitewashed walls. I don't think I'm going to find anything interesting in there. Okay. I think we're almost to our final destination. Oh. I heard that. I heard a noise over by that building. I should check it out. The building we just went to? The building we just passed? Well, this is another building. Or around the other side of the building. There doesn't seem to be anyone here. Well, I think I've explored the whole park. Have I been stood up? Just my luck. No, I can't always be so negative. So negative. Okay, she'll turn up. I just need to keep looking and be patient. The trams aren't too reliable. Perhaps she's just caught up in traffic. Maybe I should just go back to that duck pond. Maybe we should check out the door. Strange place for a desk chair. It's got weird stains on it. No thanks. It's a door. Hello? Hello? The door is locked. Alright. Hopefully that actually... Let's say we could... I thought we could, like, auto-travel back somewhere. Oh, bushes. I didn't see that. These bushes mark the end of the path. Unless I find a machete, I'm not getting through there. So he wants to head back for the pond, but which pond? The one with the gardener, or the first one? He's gone. The garter is gone. He's left his bag behind. There was something a bit weird about him. I can't quite put my finger on it. Oh well, not to worry. I worry too much. He might be back any moment. I don't want to be caught rifling through his things. Oh, rifle through the things, will ya? Alright. So now what? She's not here. I'll assume nothing's changed with the gate or the statue or anything. Ah, mother and child are back. Still no sign of Catarina, though. Oh! What the hell? Exactly.